coming to you from the Saibono Discovery Center out in Newtown, Johannesburg. And today's backdrop for the Art Bulletin is the first annual Showbiz Entertainment and Arts Expo. Welcome to it. I'm Dumisi Dumedi, and thank you very much for staying with us. Philemon Hlongwane's latest exhibition titled The Kunu Drawings has opened at Everard Reed in Johannesburg. This exhibition was inspired by the artist's visit to Kunu, and according to its curator, it's a series of monochromatic drawings with occasional flashes of color.
It's all about paying tribute to a very great man, Mandela, and just to see, you know, because Mandela come from the village Kunu, come from the village Tomo in Giyani, Limpopo province. So it's like even the color of the Kunu is the color like in Giyani where I come from. So it's all about like linking together my history background, because I come from that area, to make a living, to find a good grazing land in Johannesburg, same like Mandela did. To work on it, it was a bit challenging, more especially when you go to Kunu. You can see like on my drawing, it's a two people, one person, what something like that. People, they're not there. I think on that theme, people, they were mourning for the great person. And Kunu itself, it's like one of kind place that you can see that there's something going on there. There's a history behind that village.
Savannah Audience Choice Award winner Mdu Elton Dooley will take his audiences at the Soweto Theatre next week, Saturday. This is part of the Comics Choice Award Showcase, and he'll feature, among others, Lois Okola and Cape Town-based funny man Kagiso KG Mukhadi.
I'm a different comedian who does different jokes about different people. What people can expect from me, it's a heritage month, it's September. I'll be talking about different languages and different cultures. So I think people will relate. Sharing the stage with Lois Ogola means a lot to me, and Mark Banks, because you know that guy is, those guys are the only guys I see on TV. I think it's a dream come true, because you know you would see them on TV and think that one day it just happened. I think I'm just happy, I'm so excited, and it's a dream come true.
South African literary giant Ivan Vladislavic and German author Felicitas Hoppe will be part of New South African Voices. The next edition of The Gathering will put under the spotlight literary production and how authors find new topics.
It's part of the what we've been having for the past 2 years now of the Goethe Institute, the New South African Voices, where we take a new voice and an established voice. But this time, we are looking across the borders of South Africa. As you know, Ivan has been writing for many years, and also Ms. Hoppe has been writing for many years, one specializing on biographies, and the other short stories and other forms of writing. So their contribution to literature in South Africa and elsewhere is quite tremendous. They can look forward to imbibing the information arising from the writing of these two great authors.
Author, artist, filmmaker and composer Zex Muda will headline the 6th annual Josie Book Fair, which takes place on the 26th and 27th of September. The theme for this year's fair is Reading the Word and the World, the Role of Book Clubs.
We're encouraging book clubs. So we've got special events with Zex Muda and the book clubs. The book clubs are talking about their reading. The book clubs have also been discussing the books they're reading. They're reading a lot of Zex Muda. So there's young people who are reading his novel, Melville 67, which is a lovely, I think this is Zex Muda's best book. But it also deals with very current issues for young people, you know, becoming aware of the opposite sex, becoming aware of romance, dealing with xenophobia in the new South Africa, you know. And this is a young boy called Tabang, who takes a bus from Melville and he comes to school in the city. And this is about what happens on the bus. So Zex Muda is really a great author, you know, in that sense as well, because he takes very ordinary issues which South Africans engage in, and he holds it up for us to look at ourselves.
The Sophiatown Heritage and Cultural Center has an exciting Heritage Month program, which kicked off on the 6th of September and concludes on the 9th of October. On that lineup is an exhibition of works by Blok Mudisani titled In a Way Back Home.
Our band's going to be here. People can come and they can bring picnic baskets and their own wine and snacks, and everyone's going to sit on the floor and we're just going to jam and people are just going to enjoy it with us.
It's a local community space, you know, and being from close by, we just enjoy it here, and we, it's interesting for us to explore the history that happened here. So we thought it would be a good place to come and make music, because everybody can enjoy it.
We have penciled in a number of activities and personalities. We do hope that apart from the two some you interviewed here, but we're hoping that there will be some writers who will talk on the craft.
The first ever Soweto Art Week will commence on the 23rd of September at the Soweto Theatre in Jabulani. To find out a little more about what this festival is going to entail, we caught up with the founder and director, Lunga Khumalo.
The birth of the idea came about after the success of our traveling exhibition, you know, Inkunzi Manqaba, which was successfully launched last year at the Durban Art Gallery. So our second leg of the exhibition was Soweto. So due to interaction, you know, with the larger community, art community, we figured that there's a trend, you know, of art fairs and whatnot that are happening all around. So we figured, okay, fine, let's have Inkunzi Manqaba, you know, at Soweto Theatre, and also a joint with the art fairs that are to be associated with other art fairs. And also the aim is to promote, you know, market and sell artworks by emerging artists, you know, mid-career artists and your established artists, you know, just to create a space, a platform for artists, you know, to come to Soweto and showcase freely. And also not forgetting the fact that most galleries that we have are within the northern suburbs. So we're trying to engage them as well to come through and have fun with us, you know, within this signature event.
The fifth annual Cool Ink Tattoo Expo will begin on the 19th and end on the 21st of September. The Voortrekker Monument out in Pretoria will be the base for the Body Art Festival. Here's more information in the next clip.
Cool Ink's a gathering of local tattoo artists who come to work at the show and show off the work that they've been doing over the past year or two. Also exhibitions of piercings, suspensions, and in some really cool bands as well. Not just tattoo artists, piercing artists as well, and then also a range of really cool clothing brands, jewelry, and other arts and crafts kind of that are connected to the industry. The suspension's always really cool. Just the meet and greet with all the artists that we haven't seen in a year, because we only hold this event once a year. So it's a nice opportunity for the artists to all get together and share stories and just have a nice visit.
And that brings us to the end of today's edition of the Art Bulletin, coming to you from the first ever Sea Expo taking place at the Saibono Discovery Center in Newtown. To find out more about the Showbiz Entertainment and Arts Expo, do visit www.cexpoafrica.com. To keep in touch with us, you can always tweet at MorningLiveSABC and hashtag the Art Bulletin. Until next time, it's a goodbye from us.